You took your time.
Did you wait up, Master?
I wait for no man. You look tired.
Nothing a little adventure won't fix. What news?
Ali thinks the time is right to attack the palace. The Oyun are distracted and the people divided.
Divided how?
Some are claiming the new Khalifa stole the throne from Abu Abdullah, son of Al-Mutawakkil. What do you know of him?
Little. He was there at the palace, the night his father... The night I reached into that chest. Master, have we learned anything more about the object within?
Why do you ask?
It seems a shame we know so little about something the Order prized so much. Should we not seek to know our enemies better, the better to defeat them?
Marhaban, Basim. Have I interrupted?
No. We must turn to the task at hand.
Of course, Abu Abdullah. Rebecca tells me you have met his mother, Qabiha.
I did. I think she could be first among our foes. She, or Arib the poet, or Muhammad the governor. All three had ties to our enemies.
Muhammad ibn Tahir. His cousins govern the land on which Alamut sits.
Their protection is all that shields us from our enemies.
I cut our enemies' legs beneath their master. Let me strike while their stumps are bloody. I will unmask them and learn their intent.
Basim is right. We must act swiftly.
Go to the Round City. Investigate all three, but take no further action. Reports back to me atop the house of the previous hill.
And concubine. I will soon know which one wears the mask. They say the harem is home to hundreds, secluded and kept from sight of men. This place may be more secret than Alamut. Vulav, my finder of facts, my fielder of questions.
How can I be of help, Basim?
Tell me about Arib. Her words were as scripture to members of the Order.
A gifted artist and poetess, Arib won her freedom through her skill. Tabit tells me she keeps a luxurious home in the Round City. Anything else?
What do you know of Qabiha? She had ties to the treasurer.
Born to slavery, Qabiha rose to become Al-Mutawakkil's favorite concubine in the harem. Yet her son was not made Khalifa, leaving her future uncertain. Anything else?
Tell me about the governor. I saw him give orders to Wasif at Turki.
Muhammad is one of the Tahirids, powerful viceroys of the Khalifas in Persia. He governs all Baghdad from his seat at the courts. Anything else?
Where can I find our suspects?
All three live within the glorious Round City, the power center of the Abbasid Khilafah. Anything else?
Shukran. There, one of the Thaabin members. I should investigate.
Hey! Leave!
Did you yourself yet?
I will kill you!
Another shot.
I will not fail!
Die, you! Have you heard sentiments expressed in sympathy?
Good to see. What have you got?
The tools do make a difference. Yes, all right. Got what you needed. Please, have a look around. Very well.
I will see you.
Farewell, then.
Citizens! Are your meals bland and dull?
Rumors of my villainy. Greatly exaggerated. Could you silence those who smear me? They say no man may enter the harem unless he is a eunuch or the Khalifa himself. I am neither, so this could be interesting. What beautiful homes. Far different from the slums of Anbar.
Show me everything.
I need your eyes, my friend.
Oh,
Let us hope she is home.
You will not bar me from my guest. This is my house.
Bought with my generosity.
Bought by my genius.
For tokens, favors, and personal dedications, you may find Sayyida Arib in the garden after her recital. Good day.
You must be her patron.
It is an honor, Sayyidi. If I may, I seek a private audience with the poetess.
Do you?
I have been moved beyond words by her words. Symmetry of sky and sea. I only wish to express my sincere admiration.
Pretty words. Nearly as pretty as hers, and just as false. We both know what mask she wears, don't we?
Mask, Sayyidi.
Enough, Sayyidi. I know what you are, and I know why you've come. You think I haven't seen you skulking in the shadows. She's no longer party to your plots, your secret meetings, your foolish nicknames. I have scrubbed her clean of them. For I have set a watch on her door. My men dog her recitals. Every letter she's had of you I have shredded or sent back.
Sent back?
You will find them piled at the postal bureau. Burn them. Bury them. Do what you will. You can choke on them for all I care.
Foolish nicknames, secret meetings. The patron may have thought me a member of the Order of the Ancients. The piles of letters at the postal bureau may reveal more. Let us see what mask you wear, poetess.
Not interested. Go.
The postal bureau. I will do as the Hoyun do. Sift through strangers' mail and sniff out conspiracies.
You know, it wasn't Sajjad that led the charge into the riot. It was me.
There must be mail here from every corner of the Khilafah. Now to find Arib's. Silence your song of sin, or I will do it for you. How kind. Moving on. Dearest Arib, your poetry has touched me deeply. You are my oasis, lush and yerlqorof. After the honey drips from her lips, a Thalib leaves the garden and follows the mouse. Secret order correspondence? Bad poetry? A bit of both? Arib could be a Thalib. The patron spoke of a recital in the gardens. I could give this letter to Arib and see where the vixen leads me. I will go to the garden, give Athalab her letter, and follow where she goes.
Desert, cobra, dove, all shapes and humors will I embrace. Hello there. Have we met? Come, don't be shy. I rarely bite and I never leave a mark. It seems there's no privacy in the public eye. How came you by that letter? Who put you up to this?
I work in the dark to serve the light.
I've met the men who serve the light. It seems its glare oft leaves them blind. Are your masters so blinkered and bumbling?
You were warned, you son of a dog. Come, Areep. We will set no tongues to wagging here.
Yours is the tongue that will not still itself, even when I beg for silence.
You spurned the counsel of he who raised you, and without whom you would still be nothing?
I raised myself. I authored myself. I have written myself into history. You are banished from my pages. Now be gone!
How can I leave you to wolves such as these? You're a woman alone, unarmed.
Words are weapons enough for me.
Then let us see what defense they offer. Take her.
There is somewhere the Sayida needs to be, and you are delaying her.
It seems that words can summon shields.
We will need to make this quick.
Down with you!
Need not fly.
Areep has left for her secret meeting. I must hurry. The letter commanded Athalam to leave the garden and follow the mouse. Perhaps Areep is not lost to me yet.
Hey! It's him! Gar! He's over here! Get him! Criminal dog! You'll get your doom! Gar! Gar!
The things that pass for art these days.
Stop that killer!
sure.
You should bring him before the Medallion Court.
But he thinks only of my reputation, Sara. To safeguard success, I must be palatable, discreet. He fears I am too proud.
You? Never.
I write that love is feral and free, unbound by stricture or statute. Should I not practice what I publish?
Practice makes perfect. It also makes enemies.
So be it. But let me choose them. Courtiers, caliphs, patrons, partners. So many men have tried to decide my enemies. And friends.
Though Allah knows I once chose poorly, he hid himself well. And a poet needs patrons. Even one so great as Al-Talab.
Well, I have my pick.
Good. There's troubled times ahead.
I will be fine. I have survived 6 caliphs. I will survive...
6 more.
Don't worry, Sara. I'll kiss the rings I need to kiss, but I will not be bound again. Not by anyone.
Secret meetings. Coded names. There is no trace of the Order here. Still, she has her pick of patrons. Maybe the head of the Order is not Harib herself, but an admirer. What do you see, Enkidu? Courts are close. Derwish once told me it is where the commons can appeal when justice itself is dealt unjustly. My father once said, to know the measure of a man, ask those who work beneath him. These judges must know the governor better than most.
Incredible, the stories I hear. Lady Arib seems to write 10 new songs every day. It is no wonder her excess is not boring.
Tell me what's going on.
Won't run so well once I pluck those eyes out.
Got you!
Did you hear how he ruled? Ridiculous.
Greetings, Sayyidi. I wonder if I could ask you some questions about the governor, Muhammad ibn Tahir.
I am not underpaid to answer questions. I suggest you make this worth my time. Otherwise...
Would you accept this token of appreciation from a humble citizen?
I would. As a start.
I serve justice, not spoil it. Take your money. Now, what do you know about the governor?
He's feared, respected, dedicated to the rule of law, order.
That is all you know. You work here. Muhammad ibn Tahir keeps office at the courts.
At the shorter courts, not the Mathalim. He does keep spies here. One scuttles back to his office every day at noon. Goodbye now.
That messenger could lead me to the governor's office, and whatever secrets he buries there. Good enough. Tomorrow it is, and I must remain unseen. Lead on. Show me where I need to go. Lost. I can almost hear Roshan scolding me now. Perhaps I can redeem this failure tomorrow. I see you now. Come, lead me to what it is I truly seek.
حسناً الآن، ذلك غريب.
Found you. You could lose me.
Go away.
Hold on! Grant me strength!
They are gone. The fear was too hasty. Tomorrow I must be better.
Stop it!
must be whom I seek. Let us see where you lead me. Derwish always warned me I would be dragged to the Shurta. Who would have imagined I would walk in willingly?
That led the charge into the riders. It was me! He was too busy pissing himself.
You ever think about being old? I mean, too old to do this? My knees are already aching. My eyes aren't what they used to be.